It's the night before the Pikes Peak Writers Conference, and I'm very excited. I was up at the Marriott a little bit earlier today interviewing Chris Mandeville, and that was loads of fun. Tomorrow there's going to be lots of classes and a steampunk dinner, which is going to be fabulous. I'm wearing a 1910 walking dress that I actually converted to look a little bit steampunkish. Have a great hat to go with that. Saturday, going to be more excellent classes, lots of networking. I'm very excited to meet tons of new writers and excited just to hear about all the different projects that are happening right now. On Sunday, I'm teaching a class called Unlocking Personification and Metaphor to Deepen Emotion. I think I'm most excited about teaching that class. So we'll see what happens at the Pikes Peak Writers Conference. I made it to the Pikes Peak Writers Conference. It's Friday, but I actually realized something very important. I forgot my tea, my honey, and my half and half. Every time I go to a conference, I always bring my own tea, honey, and half and half, because as you know, a lady must always be prepared for tea. Driving in the car, totally forgot it. But I got here and I saw this. Look who I found in the elevator. It's Evangeline Denmark. You remember her from the interview I did about her awesome book, Curio. Let me tell you something that goes on at writers' conferences.
Wait, do you want to hear what my book is about?
Why would I want to hear about your book right now? I'm in the elevator.
Well, because I have an elevator pitch.
You have an elevator pitch?
Yes, my book is about a girl who gets stuck in an enchanted curio cabinet.
An enchanted curio cabinet?
Yes.
Well, this is what happens at writers' conferences. You have to be able to pitch your book sometimes to editors or agents on the fly. It's Friday evening and the day is done. We've had a fantastic steampunk dinner with Gail Carriger doing the keynote. Earlier, I took a workshop of hers where she was talking about Gothic literature and how that's influenced modern literature, and that was so much fun. Just all of the different Victorian facts that she brought in there, that was fantastic. We just got to do a photo shoot, which was tons of fun, and I got some really cool shots of Evangeline Denmark. And she's actually taking this video right now and smiling while I'm talking. Earlier today, I was doing a reading critique with Cindy Madsen, and what happens in that is that writers bring the first two pages of their manuscript, and then they read it, and then they get feedback. And I was able to give some feedback, and that was really special to be able to encourage some writers. So now I'm going home, and I'm excited for tomorrow.
I'm here with Michaela, and some very exciting news is that this has been her first writing conference. Michaela, what has this experience been like for you?
Oh my gosh, it's been thrilling, so amazing. The camaraderie here is fantastic. The creativity is astounding. I mean, the world screams at you all the ideas, and there's just so much invigorating, inspirational messages through every single workshop.
It's, absolutely.
Yeah.
And what is it that you write? What's your genre?
I write fantasy and suspense.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And Michaela had some very exciting news this weekend. She did pitch.
Yes, I pitched and they requested my manuscript.
Mm-hmm.
So, yay!
So you're all excited and fired up and ready to go home and conquer the world.
Yes. Edit.
Yes. Yes. And I'm sure you will be seeing Michaela on the bookshelves.
You will.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you.